Welcome back, friends. Today we'll start class B, IP addresses. Here we know very well the total IP address length is 2^32 bit, that is 32 bit. Okay, in this total length we are dividing 4 byte separately. We know already about the class A. In a class A, the network ID having 8 bit for network ID and the rest of the 24 bits for the host ID. But here the first 2 byte for the net ID and the rest of the 2 bytes for host ID. Okay, so let's come here. First of all, we'll discuss about the range of class B IP address. We know the range of class A, that is 0 to 127. Now here the range of class B, that is 128 to 191. Now here the first question is what about the range. Whenever the question comes in exam, what is the range of class B, then you must be remember the range of class B, that is 128 to 191. Okay, now next, here the number of networks in a class B, these are 1634, and the number of hosts are near about 65536, not exactly 36. Why? Because of we are not able to use 2 IP addresses for a particular host. That's why 65536 minus 2, which is equals to 65534. Okay, now here why we are using only 65534 instead of 65536. These 2 IP addresses are not used by the host. Why? I will tell you later. Now here network IP address, one of this from them, and the another one is what? Broadcast. Okay, we'll see later. Now here the number of IP addresses are in a class B, these are what? 2^30. Means in a class B, the total number of IP addresses are available are 2^30. Okay, now see here, suppose if we are dealing with class B IP address, then here the first octet, that is in a first octet there is 2 bits are fixed, means prefix. In a class A, the one bit is prefix, that is 0. In a class B, the first 2 bits are prefix, that is 1, 0, and the rest of the bits are any combination of zeros and ones, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is 1 byte, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is second byte, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Third byte, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is 4th byte. Okay, these are the total 32 bit, and from this 32 bit, the first 16 bits for what? For net ID, and the rest of the 16 bits for host ID. Okay, but here suppose if someone asks you, here suppose I am giving you the example 130.2.4.0, this IP address belongs to which class, then you don't see the rest of the octets, you just concentrate over the first octet and check it if that number is belongs to the range of given IP addresses. Okay, so here 130 is belongs to this range, and the range is what? 128 to 191. Then we are surely say here this IP address is belongs to class BIP address. Okay, now next here, suppose in this we are not able to make a change in these 2 bit, the rest of these 6 bits may be changed either 0 or 1. Okay, means here we can change use any number of combination of zeros and ones instead of these 2 bit. We cannot be make a change. Why? Because of these are the prefix bit, means they are help to check the category of class. So that's why these are already prefixed by the developer. So we cannot be check this prefix bit, as in a class A the 0 is prefix. We are not able to change 0. Okay, rest of the bits we may change. Okay, now here suppose the first IP address from this class A, it may be suppose 0. Okay, so here this is the first IP address from this network. Suppose we are having a network of our college or any company, so the first IP address means this IP address cannot be given to any host. Why? Because of this IP address belongs to this network. Okay, the first IP address is used to for that network, not for the host of that network. And the last would be what? The maximum value, means this range value, that is what, 191. Suppose here if I am using 191.255.255.255, this IP address is also not used to any host. Why? Because of this IP address used for broadcasting. Okay, so here that's why we are using here -2. Okay, the total address space is what? 65,536. But these two IP addresses, first and last IP address, we are not able to give to any host. So that's why we minus these two address, and the rest of this 65,534 address are available for the host. Okay, thank you for watching my video. Please like, share and subscribe my YouTube channel Dharaz Infotech, and please don't forget press the bell icon for getting the notification of upcoming videos.